By 4 o'clock, he was in intensive care unit. By 7 o'clock, he had a nasal gastric tube so that they would keep his stomach empty. And by 10 o'clock, he was under artificial respiration. So, you know, it just went bang, 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 bang. And he never woke up from that. And he had, well, everybody knew that he was HIV positive. And it just, in the summer, got him tested, and his T cells, his T4, were in almost 270, 280s, you know? So he was doing okay. And then all of this happened, and it just, like, it just took over. It just escalated, and then he had a total body shutdown. And he just, you know, went. It was, like I said, it was as if it was all meant. You know, and I'm still stuck, you know, in his house. I still don't put the butter there because he hated the butter there, you know? I made the pork with sugar and it's fluffed up. Because that's the way he liked it, you know? And I'm like, and don't undo it this way, and keep the toilet cover down because it wastes, it drains the house of the energy. So y'all remember that, and close the toilet cover because it will drain your house of energy. Before we left. And now I go around closing the toilet seat and I have it like this thing. I'm gonna miss him so much. My mama, she wanted to be here, but she can't be here. She's having a really hard time. It was the firstborn, he was the baby, she loved him. She breastfed him like in 4 years. She just really loved him so much. He just was, and you know, he spoiled her. He just spoiled her, he loved her. He sent her and she said, no, I don't want anything this year for my birthday, nothing. He never listened to that. There's something that, I'm just gonna say a few things that make me feel good when in my readings, and I'm gonna share it with you. And this is with by Miguel Ruiz, The Four Agreements. And he says, when you know that the power that is life is inside of you, you accept your own divinity, and yet you're humble because you see the same divinity in everyone else you see. And how easy it is to understand God, because everything is a manifestation of God. The body is going to die, this mind is going to dissolve also, but not you. You're immortal. You exist for billions of years in different manifestations because you are life, and life cannot die. You are in the trees, the butterflies, the fish, the air, the moon, the sun, and wherever you go, there you are, waiting for yourself. You know, I'm sure that every one of you guys have heard Elaine say, it is what it is. So, you know, I used to call him with these stories and he'd say, sister, it is what it is. You know, that don't make me feel any better now. And Ram Dass, he says, people treat love like it's an amount. It's like a light, it radiates. And that is what Alain was. He was a radiating light for all of who knew him. And then when I thought that, Stanley said that to me, and I thought that, and I said, you know, it's like the sun. You know how when it came in, the sun shined enough, and it didn't shine more on me, or it didn't shine more on Liliane, or on my son Jean-Francois. It shined on all of us the same. And I think that Alain's love shined on all of us in that same intensity. If you knew him, he was just, you know, he gave hugs like nobody gives hugs. I bet you all of you know that, right? That just in that smile and that you felt like that you were very special to him. You were. Alain's death has brought all of us closer to the reality of impermanence. You know, that we're not here forever. And I'm still, you know, can't believe that he's gone. And maybe this gives us a motivation to stay mindful and to practice kindness and forgiveness and love with all the intensity that we need to practice it. Wake up to the fact that we can bring forth the fullness of this lifetime.